we heard a very positive message from President Al-Jarba, who made a very strong statement of commitment to the unity of Syria, to democracy, and to plurality. He condemned extremism and he rejected terrorism. No, he did not raise that with members of the Security Council, though he did refer to the fact that there were some countries who were continuing to arm the regime.
You know, he has said, in really without any conditions, he has said, we want to go to Geneva II, to Geneva II. He simply said, I think he stated the obvious. He said, in Geneva I, we're supposed to have a transition government with full executive powers. He simply said, full executive powers means, of course, the control of security, the army, and the police. As how can you imagine a real transition government in the middle of a civil war, you know, without the control of the army and the security? It's very clear, all the executive powers, and it means what it means. He clearly recognized that there were radical groups now in Syria and on both sides. He simply said that these groups are foreigners. They are contrary to the Syrian way of thinking, way of living. And he emphasized also that it's important to say that you have Al-Qaeda on one side, but the other side, you have also the Iranian Pasdaran, you have also the Hezbollah. So there are a lot of radical groups.
Certainly, this meeting was not about any kind of official recognition of the national coalition, and there was a very clear understanding to that effect among members of the Security Council. I think that still there are sort of good chances for the Geneva II to be convened, because the alternative would be so horrifying. So it's definitely better to keep trying. Thank you.